Chef Jennifer Booker, the owner and executive chef of Your Resident Gourmet. Today, I'll show you how to use a gravy separator. We only need one piece of equipment, and that's our gravy separator. Today, I'm using a beef stock that still has the herbs and spices that it was cooked in. For your gravy separator, it's better to have one that has your measurements so you know how much stock you have to make your gravy or to make your sauce. For example, this particular separator lets you know how many ounces you have so that you can make the best gravy possible. It also has a nice little strainer so that it catches all of the herbs, spices, vegetables that are in the stock that you don't want in your gravy. For today, I'm using a beef stock, and I also have fresh herbs and a bay leaf that I use to cook the stock with. Very simple to use. I'll put our strainer on the top, and I'll carefully pour in our stock. Now, as I pour, I'm sure you'll notice that the strainer does a great job of catching the bay leaf and the herbs. You may also notice that the oil is starting to separate away from the beef stock and gather on top of the stock, so that when you pour, you know that you get just the stock and you leave the oil. Let's give it just a second to settle down, and then we'll pour back into our container without the fat. You may ask why use a gravy separator. The best reason is so that you have a fat-free product and you make a gravy that isn't greasy and it has the flavor of your product instead of the flavor of oil. We can use this for beef stock, chicken stock, vegetable stock, and even seafood or fish stock. So let's go ahead and pour it back into our container. You'll notice that it does a great job of keeping the oil in the gravy separator, the herbs and spices and bay leaf that we don't want in the strainer, and the fat-free stock in our container.